Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. Today we are going to be starting up Mass Effect Andromeda. Heard some mixed reviews on this, mostly ranging in the 6 to 7 range, so expectations are too high, but I'm looking forward to this. I went a little conservative on the settings. I did do a little testing, and I went a little conservative just to make sure it didn't drown out my voice too much, so did go a little conservative, like always, guys. I'll get these things hammered out in the next episode, maybe two. And we'll be good to go from there, but it's time to hop into this. Let's hop into some character customization. Now, with some of these games, I take like forever to customize my character before I just say F it and we just hop in. This time, doesn't look... I did watch a little character customization so I could kind of pre-plan in my head. I don't like how the female characters look, really, so I'm going to play in as a male character. And it just kind of, just the character models are kind of weak. But let's get into this. Going to be the male gender, so let's go ahead and customize my appearance. Let's see. Definitely not that one. Find myself a good preset. The one good thing is I care a whole lot less about how my male characters look, so should be able to hammer this out pretty quickly. So let me do it, look at it from like a side angle there. I don't want that dude. Let's see. I might go with head one. I kind of actually like the preset one. That's not bad. I want to be an old guy. No. Go with head four or head one? We go with head one. Alright, so face, skin tone. So I'll kind of make him to mirror me. Probably like a tanner skin tone, I guess. Let's see, how about like. About like that skin tone, brow height, like some of the stuff, like I can mess with it to make the character look better. But sometimes when I like mess with some of this crap, don't even see the difference here. Like I honestly don't see the difference between 10 and 0. Okay, so let's go to the cheek. That just moves the cheek. Okay, I don't want that in the middle. The cheek width. Does it look like... Okay. Let's see. I'm gonna put that as 5. What does this do? That just like moves in... Okay. Let's put it at 5 as well. Alright, chin... Alright, chin is something like I really don't want to mess with too much. Yeah, let's move in that jaw. Not too far. Like there, I think that looks... I think that's looking decent. Alright, eyes. Alright, I really don't want to mess with the eyes, because you can really jack up the way a character looks. Like what's... Oh, this moves... Okay. I see the eye movement there. Okay, just gonna leave that. Yeah, I can't mess with that. I don't want to mess with those. That's looking good. Let's move that down a little bit. I'm trying to look. Okay, that's not... let's go with 11. I'm not messing with the nose. Alright, let's go to the hairstyles. Okay, let's start at 0. I'm assuming this is... Okay, it's not bald. It's probably like the most similar to my hairstyles we got going on in here. No, maybe that's more... I don't have that like swoop thing up at the front. Okay, I'm not doing that hairstyle. It looks like a bowl. And that one's decent. If there's some crazy hairstyle that I like that's not anything like my hairstyle, I might go with it anyway. Like this, I kind of like that. No. Might go with this one right here. Might go with 9. It's I don't actually, you know what, now that I look at 9 from the front, I don't really like it. Told you this would be a process to get through this. Wasn't there one or two? Wasn't there okay, 1? Was it 0? Yeah, let's go with 0, kind of like that. Is there a darker black? Yeah, there is. Want more like that right there. Can I okay, there we go. You can have no facial hair. I want no facial hair. Alright, eyes. Oh, this is kind of... Oh, good, I can just move this thing around. Where's blue? I don't actually have blue eyes, but I like blue eyes. Actually, I'll do the blue eyes on the... Let's go about there. It doesn't really matter. Alright, let's do that. Alright. No, don't want any of that, I don't think. I don't need any of that. The only tattoo I did like that I saw... who's putting that tattoo on? What is that? Where is even the tattoo here? Hold up. Oh, it's around... Dude, who's getting a tattoo around their ear like that? What are some of these tattoos? No, the only tattoo... are these neck tats. They look halfway decent, but I really don't... I don't really want them, so we're not doing any tattoos. And then the scars suck, too. I'll show a couple of them. Hold on, where... look at that scar. What are some of these scars? They don't even look like scars. What is that? Did I get attacked by a beehive? What is that? I can't use any of those scars. Alright, so let's confirm. Why does my head look too big for my body? My head looks too big for my body, and my dude looks like he's, you know, at night when you get the light shine in your eyes, yeah, he looks like he's freaking just stunned. Okay, so custom, okay, we got all of that. What is, check this option to upload your character. Where you can re-import it in the future or share it with your friends. Oh, okay. That's kind of cool. Gotta choose training. So, got security. During your Alliance military service, you focused on learning everything you could about weapons and tactics. Concussive shot fires a seeking high-impact round to knock down opponents. Grants a massive short-term boost to weapon fire rate and thermal clip efficiency. You were effectively designated biotic during your Alliance military tenure, assisting your cohorts with your ability to control mass effect fields. Use your biotic powers to hurl an opponent through the air. Create a vortex that will trap and disable enemies caught in its field. Bolster your defenses with a powerful biotic barrier. That's looking like what I'm going to pick as of right now, but... As a technician in the Systems Alliance military, you learn to operate drones and hack enemy systems, unleash a electrostatic discharge that deals high damage to shields, hack into your opponent's armor and weapons, infecting them with a computer virus to weaken their defenses and even spread to nearby ooh, that's kind of nice. That's kind of cool. Develop specialized technology to bolster the survivability of your... okay. Alright, so that one's pretty leader. You are a team player and a natural leader in the Alliance military, working closely with your cohorts for their safety and the safety of others. Energy drain your target shields to replenish your own. That's kind of nice. Weave a shifting aura of mass effect fields around you to slowly damage it. Okay, that's kind of cool. Develop specialized technology to bolster survival. Okay. Oh, wait, no? Everything does not... Okay. Not all of these have team support. Okay. Scrapper. When a fight broke out, you were always the first soldier in the thick of it, mostly according to Alliance military protocol, and occasionally not. Charge. Grants increase. I don't really think I need that one. Wait, so the unlocked skills for some of these are just... Oh, that's stupid. See, like, you can just unlock another version, or I don't know what that means, other than you just get two unlockable skills. In the Alliance military, you study covert operations. Ooh, employ light blending technology to become invisible for a short duration. Gain a large bonus when you break cloak to attack. Alright, I kind of like Technician. Can chain to multiple. Hack into your opponent's armor and weapons. Yeah, I think I'm going to go Technician. Alright. I'm going to use my own name. Make it nice and simple and use my real name. Do you have to... I guess you don't get to change the last name. Alright, that's fine. Alright, so now we gotta customize the twin, customize appearance. I guess it tries to match. I'm gonna say screw it, we're not gonna pick a matching twin, even though that makes the most sense. Like, look at these female presets, like, they're all pretty bad. This is why I didn't want to be a female character. Like, what is that? She's got the crazy eyes. Like, what is that? We might just roll with this blonde chick, wherever she is. Was she 5'3"? 3. Like, we don't look anything like we're twins. Your appearance customization choices. Please don't say that reset. Don't say that reset. Okay, it didn't reset me. Okay. Okay, like, I'm just gonna roll with the default female character. I don't know how much importance she has in this, but I really just want to make sure I customize myself. Which I think I look fine, look good. Like, the female characters, they all look like they don't want to be in the game. Like, they just look pissed off. Alright, so let's customize history. Commander Shepard was male, or Commander Shepard... Okay, I'm gonna go off of what I played as. In my Commander Shepard's, like, Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3, I played as a female, so we're gonna have female Shepard as their current history, and I think that'll do it. I think it's time that we can hop on into the gameplay. Didn't take too long. Took about 12 minutes of customization, so not too bad. So let's go ahead. Let me look at everything. Custom appearance. Technician. Alright, let's hop into this. I was going to play on Insanity, because there is an achievement, but friends and I kind of decided it's like a two-part achievement. You can either beat the game on Insanity or beat 5 gold extraction missions, and so I'm just going to throw this baby on Normal and roll from there. Maybe in the future I'll do a playthrough on Insanity or something like that, but for now let's just enjoy the story and have a fun time on Normal. So yes, I'd like to start the game. Hopefully the audio for the game is all well and good, and we won't have to edit any of that too much, or that it's, like, too overwhelming. But let me shut up, we're about to have some dialogue from the game. Okay, I thought we were, and then it decided to... Okay, here we go. Electronic Arts presents. A BioWare production.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream. Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it. We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species. Some for discovery, to see the unknown. Others for a new start. But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for humanity. Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
In the year 2185, humanity lives in a golden era of interstellar travel. Our discovery of ancient alien ruins on Mars propelled our understanding of science and technology ahead of by thousands of years. While many a... I should have read that. Faster. That was my bad, I didn't read it fast enough. 634 years later.
Deep breaths. You're gonna want to take it easy.
I've been taking it easy for 600 years.
Ryder, Recon Specialist, Pathfinder Mission Team.
Pathfinder team, eh? The ones finding us a home.
Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean, summer year-round?
How about we get him a cup of coffee first?
Process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy.
Ryder, let's get you checked out. Look here.
After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or golden worlds, the Helios cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity.
Makes it sound so easy, doesn't it?
Okay, so here we go. Tone of choices. Tone choices help define Ryder's personality. Okay, so heart is emotional. Gear is logical. I'll describe it as the at symbol is casual, and then, like, a squared at symbol is professional. So, that's casual, that's professional. Let's just be casual.
I hope not. I signed up for a little adventure before we settled down.
Well, buckle up. Sounds like you'll get your wish.
Yeah.
Over here now, the Pathfinder wants you all on your feet right away. He said mission ready within the hour.
Any idea why?
No, but I'm guessing that's where your adventure comes in. Okay, everything checks out. Just one more thing before I send you on your way. Let's test your SAM implant. Sam, are you monitoring? Sam, are you online?
Yes, Dr. Tapero. Good morning, Ryder. Are you feeling well?
I feel like a 600-year-old popsicle. I hope we packed more coffee.
Readings confirmed. Based on the levels of adenosine in your system, the neural implant is functioning properly.
Wait, adeno what?
It just means you're still shaking off your nap. No reason why we can't get you on your way. Though you may want to hang around while we revive your sister, it always helps to see a familiar face.
I don't like the sound of that.
What's happening?
It broke free!
Just hang on!
Engineering, report!
Try to brace yourself!
Gravity and cryo bay is offline.
Careful of the syringe!
I'm almost inside! Hold on!
This is Cora. I'm at the cryo bay. Brace for a reset. Everyone okay?
I think so.
What happened?
We're not sure. Sensors are scrambled. But it's good to see you're up. Feels like centuries since we spoke.
This is the Pathfinder. Mission teams continue preparations. Cora, Riders, report to the bridge.
You heard him. Let's get...
We have a problem over here. It's Sara Ryder.
What's wrong?
I don't know. Have to check it out.
Give it a second for the processor to sync.
Did the seals break?
No. Physical.
Ryder?
Is my sister okay?
Sarah's fine. Her vitals are strong. But the revival procedure was interrupted.
Gravity systems have been restored.
When can she wake up?
We don't want to rush it. Sam?
My connection to Sarah's implant was suspended. However, her pulse, respiration, and brain activity are all normal.
To be on the safe side, we'll need to keep her in a low-level coma for a while, then let her body regain consciousness naturally. She'll be fine.
Glad to hear it.
Thanks, Lexi. Keep us updated.
I need damage assessment updates on the double.
Ryder, I'll wait for you at the door, whenever you're ready to go.
How do you want to handle this?
All right, let's look around just a little bit.
Still in stasis. Vitals look good.
It sounds amazing, doesn't it? Right up until you lose gravity.
Hi there. I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Andromeda Initiative. I'm here to welcome you to a whole new galaxy. The good news is, the hard part's over. We're here. If you have any questions now, just ask.
All right. Guess we'll ask a couple of questions.
At present, Ark Hyperion has arrived in the Helios cluster. Further mission updates are offline due to technical difficulties. As recon specialist, you are tasked with supporting the authentication of Golden World sites through exploration, mapping, and scientific analysis. Currently, you are to report for duty on the command bridge.
Damage control team to propulsion on the double.
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy. After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or Golden Worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity. Once the Pathfinder team's assessment is complete, Habitat 7 has been selected as the most likely candidate for colonization. Your current location is Ark Hyperion, housing the human population. Ark Parchero, the Solarian vessel, confirmed departure in 2185. The Asari ship, Ark Lucinia, confirmed departure that same year, as did the Turian Ark Natanis, embarking in 2185. The Pathfinder is responsible for exploring and assessing new worlds for outpost placement and settlement. Each Ark is led by a Pathfinder who represents their species. The active duty Pathfinder assigned to Ark Hyperion is Alec Ryder. Current duty roster shows you are assigned to the Pathfinder mission team, Specialist Ryder. The Andromeda Initiative encompasses all colonization efforts, including ARCs, Pathfinders, Outposts, and the Central Support Hub, the Nexus. The current location of the Nexus is unknown. Status of Outposts are unknown.
I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Initiative. I think it's important we take a moment to reflect on the principles that brought all of us together. It started with a vision of a better future, a vision that you shape. Life in Andromeda can be anything we dare to dream, and I'm proud to help make those dreams come true. Drop me a note sometime. I'd love to hear how we're doing.
All right. We reviewed that stuff. Let's go. I guess let's just go to the door. There's too much.
You ready?
What's wrong?
Is she coming?
Shit! Hey, up here! Whatever hit the Ark fried everything. We have to balance the power load or it could explode.
But we don't know where the fault is.
Ryder can find it. He has a scanner. Quick, Ryder, use it to locate the fault.
On it.
I'll try to get readings on the second conduit.
Hey, okay. Get on this one. I'll override the
signal. This equipment is operating normally.
It has to be here.
Hurry!
What's that?
Relay 2C shows damage from a temperature spike.
Found it! Bad relay!
Ryder, can you go reset it?
Yeah, let's put that away.
There! It's reset!
That should do it! Rerouting the current now!
The grid's recovering!
It's working!
Readings are in the range!
Thank God. That could have been the end of everyone.
Good job, Ryder. Now we can get to the tram.
Objective information is listed in the mission tracker at the top right.
We're in Andromeda and we're already scrambling.
The adventure begins.
Not sure your dad will see it that way.
There are a couple of things that I will adjust through the gameplay. There's a couple of
take us to the bridge.
There's a couple of options that I wasn't sure which one I wanted or on or off or how I wanted it, so we'll figure that out as we go. Like helmet on or off during dialogues or off completely. So we'll get into that as we play.
Helm control, report.
We're drifting.
Flight controls aren't responding.
First priority is stopping these outages.
Mainline power's been knocked out. We're on reserves, Captain. They won't last.
What's our position?
Unknown. We lost telemetry.
Sam, we need eyes out there.
Attempting to adjust sensor array.
Alec, please. You may be Pathfinder, but this is my ship.
Captain, the protocol's clear. In the absence of communication with the Nexus or the other Arcs, we proceed to our appointed Golden World. Solid ground.
If it's even out there. Nobody said anything about running into an energy cloud. And that's just a wild guess what we hit. Alec, I need to assess the damage. Stop the bleeding. We've got 20,000 people asleep on this ship. Let's give them a chance to wake up.
Can you blame her?
She is the captain. I think she gets the final word.
Well, he might.
This isn't about having the final word.
Yes, sir.
We're coming through.
My God. Is that our Golden World?
That's Habitat 7. New Earth, if we're lucky. All of our long-range scans told us it was in the green zone. Perfect for human settlement.
It doesn't even look the same.
We don't know how bad it is yet. Still seems like it's our best shot.
Maybe. There's just a lot on the line.
Sam?
The energy from the phenomenon is damping our senses. Planetary conditions are unknown.
We're marooned. 20,000 souls adrift at sea. And when the power runs out and stays out, we need to know if that's safe harbor.
And if it's not?
As Pathfinder, it'll be my job to find an alternative. It's what we trained for. But if this goes well, we're already home.
All right, just make it quick.
Harper, the rest of the team should be awake by now. Have them spin up two shuttles. Planet Fallen 30.
Yes, sir.
A stubborn one, isn't he?
He cares in his own way. Enough to give him a chance.
I suppose you're right. He is our Pathfinder. If this doesn't work out, we'll need him more than ever.
I need an ETA on our sensor repairs. We're blind out here.
My sister's gonna hate that she missed this.
Are all the Riders adrenaline junkies?
I guess it's in her blood. She beat me into the world by 1 minute. Couldn't wait to get started.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure Sara will pull through.
When she does, she's gonna want stories.
So, let's get out there and find her some. Right, you'll want to get your helmet. And maybe stop at the Good Luck Rock before we go.
The what?
It's an old superstition of your dad's.
Okay, so here's my helmet.
Got it.
The Pathfinder is now requiring sidearms. I've opened the armaments locker.
We expecting trouble, Sam?
A precaution. Please arm yourself, Ryder.
Good luck, Rock, huh?
Your dad was mountain climbing back on Earth. It caught him from falling. The way things are going today, we'll need any luck we can get.
Yeah.
All right, the good old M3 Predator. And pick that bad boy up.
You never know.
Alright, so there's a look at kind of how the combat system's gonna be. I put the gun away. Wait, how do you put the gun away? That can't be the only way to put the gun away. Well, maybe it is the only way to put the gun away. Okay. Alright, so now we need to report to the hangar bay. I think this is a good place to call it an episode. What we got here? We got other people's lockers.
Hang in there, Sara.
Oh, so we popped the locker open barely?
Looks like Dad's already suited up.
Okay, but that is going to do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I will catch you all in the very next episode of Mass Effect Andromeda. So I'll catch you guys then. Peace out.
Everything was in the clear. How could things change like that?